The famous We Love Houston sign. Now let's send it down to David Aldridge, standing by from the sidelines. David?
Well, guys, we know that the Rockets begin and end with the offensive wizardry of James Harden, the league's MVP in 2018. Now, some people have said they don't like watching that style with one player dominating the basketball. But, Kevin, James Harden is that good, that talented, that efficient, and that successful. And playing through him may be the best way for the Rockets to be successful as well.
It's tough to stop. You're right, D.A. Thank you. And here's a look at some numbers for McLemore.
And you can see the surge in his level of confidence lately. Just by looking at that true shooting percentage, it's been moving straight up in the past five games. I think he's feeling it.
Let's take a look at our starters for Sacramento. Hield and Barnes are the two and the three. Rashawn Holmes out there with Bialica. And it's Joseph in at the point. And for the Rockets, Tucker and Capella are up front. Westbrook and Harden, the dynamite pair. They're the backcourt. And it's House in at the three spot. Clark, here we are in midseason, and some teams have already exceeded early expectations, starting to show that they are the real deal.
Yeah, no fluke, and that's what we call validation. Again, you have such a long season early on, the schedule can work in your favor, but as we get to this point in the season, Kevin, teams are starting to show you who they really are, answering doubters, and it's got to be extremely satisfying when you prove folks wrong.
Absolutely. Barnes. And plenty of contact on the shot, so two free throws coming up. And Houston gets called for the foul.
And I think Barnes is an impressive athlete, Kevin. Now, you can say that for a lot of guys in this league, but he excels at reading the defense and forcing the issue.
That's good from Barnes.
The seventh overall pick in 2012 out of North Carolina, Harrison Barnes won a title in Golden State, signs the big contract with Dallas, but yet to achieve the stardom that many predicted back in high school.
Barnes hits them both. Greg, you look at Harrison Barnes. What's his best role?
I mean, Kevin, he's a hard worker, able to hit the spot up three. Defensively, his strength gives him some versatility, just a solid contributor.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Bielitsa. Sacramento on defense. Here is House. Six to shoot. Harden inside the three-point line. Rebounded by Holmes. And so it's Joseph with it. He'll bring it up for the Kings. Hield kicks to Joseph. Back to Hield. A three ball. Drills the three-pointer.
And that is what Hield does. This guy is a gunner. Loves pulling the trigger from deep.
Here's Harden, and it's denied. And now Sacramento on the break. Ahead, and the dunk by Barnes.
Great teamwork, punctuated by a strong finish.
That is the perfect fast break, guys. Getting a hoop before the defense can get set.
Now, here is Harden. Last game, he had 34 points.
And, you know, when you get a clean look at the rim, Harden usually will find you. I think he's underrated and undervalued at making his teammates better.
Here's Barnes. It's a five-point game. Holmes passes to Hield. His second shot goes in, off to a good start, two for two.
Talk about a great start. Three of three from the field to get the game going. They're cooking with gas, folks.
From deep, Harden sinks the triple.
And Harden's three-point accuracy is lethal. I mean, he gets his shot off with such ease and quickness.
And here in the first, approaching 3 minutes played. Hield against Harden. Hield can't hit.
That's the kind of D you need when he's got the ball near the hoop. They were all over.
Here's Westbrook. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
Well, you knew after the Paul George trade that the Thunder would look to sell on Westbrook as well. Just part of the rebuild at this point. His agent did well to get him to a team looking to compete. A great fit for a player in this stage of Russ's career.
Take a break. Two shots.
That free throw missing.
And Russell Westbrook is as explosive a guard as we've seen in the history of the game. An incredibly gifted scorer who can also punch it on you.
And the second free throw, good. About 3 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Joseph looking over the floor. And the officials will call the illegal screen right there.
All right, a chance to check out the stats for Hill.
He's been in good form here the last few weeks, putting up about 22 points per, 5 rebounds, and 4 assists. And you can't help but be impressed by his numbers.
You know, guys, I think he's the engine of this offense. He makes them go. Without his scoring, I think they'd be a totally different team.
Westbrook. Whistle blows. Bucket is good. And he'll have a chance at the line to make it a 3-point play.
And, you know, Westbrook is fearless. Likes getting deep inside and finishing around the rim and plays in attack mode all the time.
And, well, whatever your feelings may be on the Rockets, you can't deny their offense works.
Yeah, it does work, really. I mean, I agree with you. Second in offensive rating last year, 4th in effective field goal percentage. This team knows what's how up? To produce points and be efficient in doing so, and they stay with their approach. They don't let teams take them off their game plan.
And it's tied up with that one. For Sacramento, they've gone 3 of 4 from the field to start out the game. Outside, Joseph. Kicks it to Dedmon. That's a 2 from Hill. Misses off the left iron.
Boy, defense non-existent there. But they catch a break as he whiffs it.
Here's Harden. That doesn't go in. Had a chance, though, to take the lead.
You know, he looks a little off-kilter to me this quarter, still trying to find his rhythm.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
Barnes against Harden. Barnes can't get it to go. And here's Westbrook. He'll bring it up for Houston. And the basket is good. Westbrook's got 6 points.
And it's the fearlessness of Westbrook. It's really refreshing to watch. When he's deep inside, he just goes right at you.
Shot by Hill, nobody around. And once again, off the mark by Sacramento. From downtown, and Russell Westbrook good for 3. Westbrook's got his 3rd bucket of the night.
Whether he's attacking the basket or squaring up from long range, Westbrook is always dangerous.
So the Kings call timeout. They're first. Clark, you know, some players just don't need a lot of rest. They could play basketball all day, every day, and don't want to be taken out. They've all got a lot of engine in them.
Yeah, they do. 24/7 guys, we call them. They don't need a lot of fuel, and it seems like they never are out of fuel. Guys like Paul George and Russell Westbrook come to mind.
Mm-hmm. Some changes for Sacramento. Lisa comes in for Barnes, and it's Bogdanović in for Hill. Joseph with the ball. No points in the game yet for him. Outside, Bogdanović. Back to Joseph. Just five on the clock. Sacramento again missing. And here's Houston. They're on a 14-2 run here. The shot's good from Westbrook.
Yeah, they're relying on their three-point shooting and getting pretty good results.
Bounce pass, Joseph. Deadman's shot is off. Look at the last game for Sacramento. It was a win against the Mavericks in Dallas.
Well, you look at the points they produced in that game. Great adjustments on the offensive end.
Well, it's really hard to stop them when they're in a groove offensively, and they were in a comfort zone all game long in that one.
Now, here's Bogdanovich following the miss by Russell Westbrook. It's stolen by Capella. 1:56 left in the first. Harden finds Westbrook. Fires the three. And it's Sacramento with the rebound. It's an 8-point differential. Westbrook against Joseph. And Bogdanovich now top the key. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
Boy, that's got to be terribly frustrating there. I mean, with the defense not hustling, and he still misses. Boy, he wishes he had that one back.
I like their focus coming in. Terrific execution so far.
And, you know, it's an all-out effort they've come in with. Very aggressive offense so far.
Now a timeout called by Sacramento. And with Clint Capella, it's easy to see what an important piece of this team he is.
Yeah, it really is, guys, because when he's off the floor, there's a clear difference in how his team plays. I mean, he fits in so well and gives the Rockets exactly what they need, finishing at the rim out of pick and rolls, and then a terrific rim protector as well.
Here to see the numbers for Russell Westbrook. 8th in assists, 9th in steals, and he's right up there in the top 20 in scoring. Certainly a force to be reckoned with offensively.
And his floor awareness is undeniable. As you pointed out, top 10 in assists, and he's great at drawing the defense and making the perfect pass in stride. Goes up the baseline. Tucker with the ball. He elites us there, and it's good for two.
Excellent all-around performance so far, hence the big lead.
Yeah, you know, they've had the advantage at both ends. They've got all the momentum early on.
Now, here's Joseph. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. And the pass to Bielitsa. The Kings need to get off a shot here. Shot by Joseph. No good.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also going their way.
Well, I don't think there's any question about it. They came focused and ready to play. I mean, they're doing everything they can to put things in their favor. You earn that, and they're actually earning it well right now.
And here's Bogdanovich. He's coming off a 10-point game against the Mavericks in Dallas. From deep three-point range, and so it's Houston looking at a 13-point lead heading into the next quarter. And if they keep draining the threes like they've been so far, their lead is safe. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. A unique upbringing for Clint Capella. Spent years in a welfare orphanage in Switzerland. He said he never imagined he'd come this far.
As a kid, I wasn't even dreaming about that far. I would say that it's even past my dreams. I mean, now I'm just living the moment, trying to work hard as I can, and just enjoy the present. Enjoy the present.
Just an inspiring story, Greg. It gives you perspective on why you should be grateful for everything you have.
Kevin, without a doubt, Capella's upbringing helped shape him, and the hard work he continues to put in is really admirable.
And welcome back to the second quarter of action. Plenty of basketball left to play, but this one has been one-sided so far. And for the Rockets here, they've been putting on a show, guys.
Well, they used the fast break to generate some easy buckets before the defense could get set.
And, you know, for them, guys, it's all about tempo. Keep the pressure on and do so as much as possible.
Tucker and Capella are up front. McLemore is up there with Russell Westbrook. And it's Cephalosha in at the three. That's the group starting the second quarter for the Rockets. On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, after years and years of rebuilding, the Kings are finally a team on the rise, and they're earning respect. Draymond Green said they've got a lot of young talent, never quit, probably the fastest team in the history of the NBA. Green said after he plays them, I leave the game exhausted. I go home, I'm dead. And Kevin, we know that Green is pretty accustomed to going all out.
David, he sure is. He's got a lot of engine in him. Thank you so much.
I'd love to see them impose themselves a little more on the backcourt. That's a great way to find confidence. Always a surefire way to get back in the game.
Well, guys, they need to do something to reduce this deficit. We'll see if that's the answer.
Here's Dedmon following the basket by Russell Westbrook. Kicks it out to Ariza. Out to the wing. Three-pointer. It's hauled in by Clint Capella. Capella's got six rebounds here tonight. Takes the three. And it's Westbrook missing. The Kings trail by 18. Bogdanovich passes to Joseph. And it's Bogdanovich off the drive. Basket is good. He'll get a chance for one more at the line.
What a play there. The hoop plus the harm.
Yeah, great concentration there, Greg. Hung in there. He didn't let that contact throw him off at all. Stayed focused on the rim, knew he was going to get hit, and still was able to finish.
Mark, you ever think we'll see a player coach in the NBA again?
I don't think so, Kevin. The role is just so demanding. You know, it requires so much, and there's so much scrutiny now. I don't think you can effectively play and coach in this day and age. No, I don't think you'll see it.
Last one we saw was Dave Collins back in the late 70s, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's right. And that's a long time ago, man.
The Boston Celtics.
Yep.
And cutting into the lead with the big one-hand throwdown.
That's how you get your team back into it.
That might indeed ignite a spark in this team.
Buries it from three-point range.
And that gets him going here in the second after hitting two from long range in that first.
Now a timeout called by Sacramento. This, of course, their first opportunity to play Houston this season.
The game is the first of a three-game season series for these clubs, both looking to take round one.
And, Greg, the first time you face a team in the season, that's when you're looking to take that mental advantage, demonstrate you're better, and that could make it easier down the road.
And the Rockets making a change here. Rivers checked in. Barnes is checked in for the Kings. Outside, Joseph. And in the second quarter, a little under 3.5 minutes played already. Here's Barnes. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. Clark, take us inside the halftime locker room in the NBA.
Well, players typically just regroup individually. There may be some conversation between the players as a group, but then the coaches will huddle, evaluate what transpired in the first half, what adjustments need to be made, and then they'll communicate that to the team. And it's basically a time to rest and regroup for the players to adjust and strategize for the coaches.
Clark, do you think there's any videotape review in there, maybe showing players certain sets, certain schemes?
In this day and age, for sure, with the use of iPads and technology, if you go back to my time, there was no quick turnaround of video in the halftime locker room.
Right, right. I do know officials do that, too, in their locker room at halftime. Tyson Chandler, he's checked in for Capella. And he makes the first, but misses the second.
And, you know, Harrison Barnes is an effective two-way player, becoming better every day on offense and can defend multiple positions as well.
Here's Joseph after Austin Rivers scored. Right side, Joseph lays it up and banks it in.
High percentage play. He's excellent around the rim.
Rockets leading by 15. Rivers dishes to McLemore. It's Dedmon with the rebound. Dedmon's got 6 rebounds now in the game. Here's Ariza. Rebounded by Tucker. The Rockets have gone 5 of 8 from the floor here in the second quarter. Over 60% shooting. Now here's McLemore. He is covered by Bogdanovich. Rocket 6. Now here's McLemore. Not a lot of room. Here's Chandler. And the shot goes down. And the Rockets lead by 17.
I mean, the number of points they've scored in the paint already here is eye-opening.
Barnes kicks to Joseph. Ariza outside. Pass to Barnes. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Barnes has got 7.
Boy, strength and body control on display there from Barnes. I will tell you what, he's got a competitive spirit to him. He doesn't want any defender to get the better of him.
And look, he's not the best athlete, but he's able to create the space he needs to operate.
Rockets with the rebound. They come into this having outplayed Phoenix the last game.
And the bench turned up in that one. Whatever they couldn't get from their starters, they got from the reserves.
Well, you know, you hear about the importance of having depth all the time, bench players that contribute. And last game, their bench came alive.
Outside, Bogdanovich. The Rockets pull it in. Tucker's got his 4th rebound in this one.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
And really a reflection of their superior effort level to this point. It seems to me they've gone after this win a little bit more.
Now here's Joseph following the miss by Austin Rivers. Barnes finds Bogdanovich, knocks down the 3 ball. Bogdanovich has got 5 points now this quarter.
And they've got to talk to each other on D there. Miscommunication, and now he's able to make them pay.
Here's Cephalosha. Dedmon with the block. Here's Joseph. And that one's good. His second basket of 4, shooting 50%.
And not a great start for him in the first, but he's quickly starting to turn it around.
Rivers passes to McLemore. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. Houston shooting their 4th and 5th shots at the foul line in the game.
Shooting 2.
That free throw good for McLemore.
Well, you know, for so long, Mike D'Antoni has been a vanguard on NBA offense. His teams have always played great offense, moving, spacing, dynamic players. Defense has not been at the level of offense, but I think he's actually improved as a coach in that area as well.
Daniel House has checked in for Houston. James Harden comes in for Austin Rivers.
Probably as close to a sure thing as you can have at the free throw line.
Pass to Barnes. 19 seconds left in the second quarter. Floats one up. It's rebounded by Houston. Harden outside. From deep. And the last second attempt doesn't fall. And through the first half, a pretty lopsided affair. Rockets ahead, up by 16. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Tyson. How have you controlled the tempo in the game in the first half?
I think the way we came out defensively, we locked into their sets. We're taking them out of what they want to accomplish. Because of that, we're able to make some shots on our end.
Tyson, thanks. We'll see you in the second half. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. And stay with us, folks. We'll be back just after halftime to get the third quarter started.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey again, everybody. So far, a pretty lopsided game, but still one half to play. I'm Ernie Johnson, joined by Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Houston holding the upper hand after the first two quarters. They're leading by 16. Kenny, what did you see from them?
Well, they built this lead in large part because of the sharpshooters off the bench. The subs played a superb game. Get it? Sub, superb. Oh, I'm rolling tonight. I mean, they played like starters.
Shaq, how do you think Sacramento played?
Well, the bottom line, they got to defend the three-point line much better. They were concentrating all their effort into protecting the paint, and these guys were standing behind the line, yakum, yakum, splakakataya. And that strategy backfired, Ernie. They gave up far too many open looks, and all those threes killed them.
And that's going to do it for us here. The second half of action is coming your way.
Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. Well, you look at Russell Westbrook in this game. He has been everywhere.
Man, he's been running wild on them through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
And you know what? I'll be interested to see just how much he's got left in the tank. That first half had to take a lot out of him.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. While we've got a moment, let's set the floor. Brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up for the second half. On the court right now for the Kings, Joseph and Hield make up the backcourt. Bialica is out there with Harrison Barnes. And it's Holmes in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Now here's Barnes. That shot missing.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
And here is Hield following Russell Westbrook's three. On the wing, Hield. He's got five, and the foul on Harden. That's his first foul. Here's Holmes. Now Joseph, who's averaging around 5.5 points a game, and it goes down 2 points. Joseph's got his third basket of the night right there.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Well, I agree with you. Four of their last five baskets have been exactly of that variety.
And here's Hield. He'll bring it up for the Sacramento Kings. The Oklahoma City Thunder will be in town for the next one. That game marks the first half of a quick two-game homestand.
Can't allow Barnes that kind of good position in the post, because once he has it, it's dinner time.
Now, here is Harden. He's got six. Capella dishes to Westbrook. Six on the shot clock. No good on that one. So the Kings will take it the other way. And Clint Capella is going to pick up a foul. That is his first foul of the game. The Kings trail by 15. Into the third we go. 2 minutes in now. Capella against Barnes. And Capella sends it back.
This is the real strength of Capella's game now. Outstanding at using his length and athleticism to block shots.
Four on the shot clock. And so it looks like the Kings will retain possession here.
Yeah, gets a finger on it, but just can't quite come up with the steal.
Clearly a careless pass. He got away with one there.
Shot clock at two. Near the three-point line, it's Joseph. Here's Holmes, and Holmes throws it down.
Just a terrific effort on the offensive glass. That's how they're going to cut into this lead.
And, Greg, a dunk like that is sure to give them a spark.
Which is a spark they desperately need, Kevin. They've got to ramp up the intensity.
And here's Westbrook from the arc. Hits the three-point bomb. Westbrook's got a pair of threes now here in the third for Houston. Outside, Joseph. Heeled outside. And again, it's Sacramento converting.
Yeah, Joseph adept at finding his open teammates, and that's exactly what you want from your point guard.
And really, for a long time, the specter hanging over Buddy Hield was he's the player who was traded for DeMarcus Cousins. Hard billing to live up to, but he has made some giant leaps with his development.
Doing all he can so far, but they still find themselves trailing.
And here's Westbrook from the arc, but they recover it. And the whistle blows as the basket counts, and a three-point play chance right here. One free throw coming up.
It's a +5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
And Hield has slowly but surely turned himself into one of the elite shooters in the NBA.
And guys, to be as locked in as he is from deep with his height and release is deadly. He's the kind of player who gets better as his teammates get better around him, and he is just now finding his stride.
And the free throw, no good.
You know, he was born in Switzerland, guys. Clint Capella's had quite the journey to NBA stardom. I mean, started his pro career in France, and he was a late first-round pick in 2014.
Just over 3.5 minutes through the third quarter of play now.
Well, that was a superb read defensively. He jumped right into the passing lane the instant the ball left the passer's hand.
Here's Harden. Money from the wing. Harden's got 8.
Now, you
got
to remember that Harden has a quick trigger, staple gun quick. This guy is looking to score as soon as the ball touches his hands.
Now here's Hield. 9 points in the game so far. Here's Joseph, and Capella sends it back, and they'll keep possession. Barnes can't get it to go.
Just not much success when it comes to shooting.
Harden draws the double. He kicks it to Capella. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
And a boon it was for the Rockets to be able to keep Clint Capella. A great fit with the team and gives them exactly what they need on the interior.
That's good from Capella. And Greg Capella, who was taken near the end of the first round back in 2014 in the draft, has developed well during his time with Houston.
And Capella's game has really taken off in the last few seasons. He looks to be a double-double machine for this team for the next handful of years, and that is exactly what they need.
Mark, I want to take you back a bit here to 1982. What was going through your mind over your first few NBA games?
Well, Kevin, first of all, I was really excited and thankful to have a chance to realize a dream, but I was also a little bit nervous going up against some of the guys that I had watched and idolized from afar. But once you're between those lines, it's not about idolizing guys. It's about trying to posterize them.
Any player in particular, one player that you looked out on the floor and you were out there as well saying, oh, my goodness, look who I'm playing against tonight.
Well, when we first saw the Celtics and the Sixers, Larry Bird and those great teams in the 80s, Cedric Maxwell and Kevin McHale, and then the Sixers, my rookie year, won it all. And they had Moses Malone, Dr. J, Bobby Jones, some of the greats in the game. So those two teams, and Dr. J and Larry Bird in particular.
Russell Westbrook really making a difference here.
And, you know, Kevin, he's on another level right now. Knocking down threes left and right. The defense isn't doing their job, and I think they've got to talk about it quickly.
And a moment now to look at the year-to-year scoring output and how it has been trending for Westbrook.
And looking at his offensive numbers from the past few years, it seems like teams around the league have kind of figured him out. He's having to work a lot harder for his points, and they haven't been coming nearly as easily as they used to. And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness, Greg. I mean, if they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
Now, here's Capella. Here is House. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Persistence pays off as they finally hit a shot. And the Rockets lead by 18. Joseph against Westbrook. Healed outside. But they get it back. Joseph down low. Guarded by Harden. Holmes, good.
Yeah, coach's pet peeve there. No box out.
Those are free points you're giving away. You got to work harder on the glass.
Now, here's Westbrook. He's got 23. Here is House. Shot clock at 6. Back to Westbrook from the arc. Ariza with the rebound. Ariza's got 4 rebounds now tonight.
You know, guys, you can tell he wants to contribute more, but his teammates have picked up the slack for him. That's what being on the team is all about.
Harden, no good. Now the feed to Barnes, and the dunk by Barnes.
Up high and down hard. Love seeing Barnes be aggressive like that, Kevin. Showing off his quickness and athleticism in a big way. How was my impression of
good?
One of your favorite lines?
I like that. You sounded great. Better than me. I love it, Clark. Good job. Drills it from outside.
In perimeter scoring, I have to imagine it was a topic of discussion at halftime.
Certainly. I mean, they saw a weakness in the perimeter defense and took advantage of it.
Heald can't hit.
Well, he had 1 3-pointer in the first half, but so far in the second, he's come up with goose eggs.
Offensive rebound. Here's Capella, and the dunk by Capella.
Boy, he's a powerful presence with great length. Capella can make things happen inside for sure.
And Joseph gets to Ariza. Here's Barnes. A second chance effort, and the layup is good. Barnes has got 6 in the quarter.
The tenacity on that interior, just battling, bringing that effort and will for second chance points.
Good on the 3-point shot. 29 points for Russell Westbrook.
The defense is far too slow to close out on those 3-point attempts.
And those triples, they sure do add up quickly, don't they? I mean, they've got to make some kind of adjustment here.
Now here's Heald. He's got 11. Drops in the layup for 2. Heald's got 13.
And you know, he's enjoyed the kind of day you expect in terms of shooting the basketball. He can bring them right back into this game.
Harden against Heald. The tray. No good. Russell Westbrook has been leading the charge for Houston. With the points he racked up that quarter, he has broken his season-high scoring mark already. We'll get right back to the action when we return. Here now a chance to show you our assist of the game, and it's presented as always by State Farm.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call court vision.
Yeah, and with the accuracy to go along with that vision. I mean, he put the ball in the absolute perfect spot. That's how you orchestrate it.
And there have been 2 very different performances from these teams today as we get going in quarter number 4. Westbrook and Harden, the dynamite pair. They're the backcourt. Then it's Ben McLemore. Then it's Clint Capella. And it's House in at the 4-man position. It's the 5 for Houston right now. And here's Bogdanovich. James Harden getting it to go from deep. Holmes passes to Hield. Tries it from 19. Rebounded by Capella. Capella's got rebound number 12 here already in the game. And the rejection by Holmes. And as it goes out of bounds, Houston able to keep the ball here. Tabo Cephalosha has checked in for Houston. And a change for Sacramento. Deadman's checked in. Here is House. Mark, the two-way contract, a relatively new invention that gives players time in both the G League and the NBA.
I love it, Kevin, because it's another pathway for those aspiring to be NBA players to have a legitimate shot to make their dream come true. The G League is just a notch below the NBA in terms of overall talent. And so I love the fact that players who desire to be pros can...
What a jam!
Are you kidding me?
Oh, that's an old-fashioned rim rap.
Just a remarkable jam. These fans' jaws are on the ground right now.
Platinum-level highlight reel material. That is showtime stuff there.
Houston leading by 23. No one near Westbrook as he lets it go. No good on the triple. To the middle. Here's Bogdanovich. Oh, yes, the turnaround.
Picture perfect with the turnaround. There's no stopping that shot.
Here is House. Ariza covering. House kicks to Westbrook. Feeds it to Cephalosha. From 18 feet away. And it's off the back rim. No good.
You know, even though they're on top in this one, you'd like him to be better out there. Because he's capable of being better. Sure would make things a lot easier, too.
And the bucket is good. Three-point play chance here for him.
And you can see what the emphasis was at halftime. Here in the second, a lot more effort to get the ball inside, and it's starting to pay dividends.
And, guys, what do you think about the offensive approach so far that we've seen for the Rockets?
Guys, how about all the second-chance points they've been able to convert throughout the game?
They haven't wasted time getting the ball up the court tonight either, and it's resulted in a lot of fast break points.
Bialica, he's checked in for Sacramento. Free throw good, Bogdanovich. Well, Greg, it took some time for Bogdan Bogdanovich to make it over to the NBA, but you can see why he was worth the wait.
And Bogdanovich showed some flashes of his great shooting that rookie year and only improved on that last season. Still, you know, in his mid-20s, he should only continue to get better as he adjusts to the NBA.
Here's Hield, and no good. Trying to use the glass. Rockets leading by 20. Oh, and there's the alley-oop, and McLemore slams it in.
Oh, such a beautiful pass to set that one up.
Yeah, the pass might have been pretty, but the finish was angry.
Well, you need both to make it special, and they pulled it off just right.
Now, here's Ariza, down to 5 on the shot clock. Over Cephalosha. But they'll get another chance. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time. Rockets have gone 4 of 8 in this fourth quarter, shooting an even 50% from the field. And here's Westbrook from the arc. Sacramento grabs the miss. Holmes got his 8th rebound here tonight. Passes it to Hield. Clark, here's kind of an interesting perspective question for you. How much of making it to the NBA is talent? How much of it is the work you put into it?
Kevin, if I were to give this a ratio, I would probably say 65% talent, 35% work ethic.
Wow.
Because you have to have a level of unique giftedness to be an NBA player. Many can work really hard and not be NBA caliber. So I think there's, I tilt that 65-35 talent to work at.
Sacramento moving it around. And there's the pass to Bialica. Back to Bogdanović. Nice pass. Led him to the rack perfectly for the layup. Bogdanović has got 9 points now in the quarter. Here is House. The rebound by Hield. Here's Bogdanović, and the Kings check on two more.
I tell you what, guys, there's not much more he can do. I mean, he's been on fire, yet they still trail in this game.
Westbrook passes to Capella. Rebound by the Kings.
And that is a textbook example of how to defend your rim.
And you know, guys, I love his fight and grit on the interior. I mean, he never lets a shot go uncontested.
Here's Holmes. No good, shot missing. Good work defensively by Capella. Ariza against Westbrook. And the rejection by Holmes. Bogdanović left side. He watches it go through the hoop for his 8th make. Now 8 for 14.
And you know, Ariza is a great value utility Velcro kind of guy. I mean, somebody that knows how to dish the rock.
And the dunk by Capella. That gives him a double-double in this one. 10 points and 14 rebounds.
Late in the game, up big, they continue to attack.
Yeah, I don't think you want to get loose and sloppy or ease up, but it is time for them to start using that clock a bit.
And every miss finds its way to his hands. Well, what an impressive performance.
Tell you what, those are crazy numbers, guys. I mean, believe me, I was a good rebounder in my day. It is not easy to corral that many boards in one night.
We've seen some ugly incidents last few years, Clark, between players and heckling fans. Can anything be done to fix it?
I think security in the arenas is important. Fans oftentimes that go across the line in interacting with players are usually fueled by alcohol. I don't know how you could control that element of it. The incidents are few and far between. We have seen a few more, but I still don't think it's an epidemic. But I think security, and then each team and each franchise should really be educational with its fans about what's acceptable behavior and what won't be tolerated.
Rivers finds Chandler. Here's Clark. Pass to Clemens. 4 on the clock. From deep 3-point range. Out of bounds, Sacramento will take possession.
And as we head to the final buzzer here, a crushing blowout, big-time dominance, and this will go in the record books as a gaudy win for the Rockets.
As one-sided as it gets today, you know, there were some dominant moments in about every facet of this game for that team.
Yeah, I mean, Kevin, it's hard to think of what didn't go right for them. Game planning by the coaches, execution by the players, everything was just on target.
And for the year now, they'll be tallying their 16th win.
And once it becomes official, this win gives them a nice confidence boost against this team. They'll face them twice more this season.
The stats tell us, Greg, that the winner of the first game is a big favorite to come out on top in the overall series.
And you know, when you look at the huge impact he had, just a monster game for Russell Westbrook.
He was doing everything right, and the points came in bunches. Definitely had the hot hand. And what a journey it's been for Austin Rivers since being drafted 10th overall back in 2012. Looked like he might not have what it takes to be an NBA player early, but he persevered and is now an integral part of this group.
And that one misses. Can't make the second free throw either. Missing both. Here's Gabriel. Farrell passes to Gabriel. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Take a break. 2 shots.
No good on that one. And he's good on the second. They are in complete control.
This is the ultimate definition of the zone. Everything they've done has worked.
Dishes it to Clark. Pass to Hartenstein. Five to shoot. Down low, Clemens. Banked in off the glass.
And you can sense that these fans, these players, they are ready to celebrate.
And I think they can start that celebration right now. I mean, what a terrific team victory.
So we see the Rockets taking the win here. And the outcome of this one was never in doubt.
And boy, they really put in a supreme effort. It just felt like once they had that lead and it was comfortable, they were not going to relinquish it.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks very much, James. Congrats on the win. What's your team's mindset right now in terms of approach?
Our consistency and our attention to detail. You know, we're a young team, but we got to focus on the small things. You know, our hard work is going to be enough as well.
Great effort tonight, James. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. And that'll do it, folks. For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our terrific 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. So long.